Hi makers, welcome to my channel. It's Sierra with Sierra's Crafty Creations, and today we're going to be crocheting this really fun waffle stitch headband. Let's jump into the materials that we're going to need to create this headband. You're going to need a worsted weight yarn. I'm using Hobby Lobby's I Love This yarn. It's a size 4. You can use any size 4 weight yarn that you want. Mine's 100% acrylic. And then you'll also be using a 4mm G crochet hook. This is a clover crochet hook that I'm using today, 4mm, and then you'll also need a pair of scissors and a yarn needle. All right, let's grab our yarn and our 4mm crochet hook and get started. We're going to start by creating a slip knot. You're going to insert your hook into that loop and pull down to tighten around your hook, and we're going to start by chaining. We are going to grab our yarn with our hook and pull through that loop there that's already on our hook, pull through, and that is one chain. Grab your yarn, pull through the loop. That's your second chain. And we're going to keep going until we have a total of 20 chains. Now we're going to get started on the very first row. And to do that, we're going to be doing double crochets. We're going to skip the first two chains and work in the third. So you're going to yarn over your hook, insert into the third chain, grab your yarn and pull through that chain, and you'll have three loops left on your hook. We're going to yarn over our hook and pull through the first two loops, and you'll have two loops left on your hook. You're going to yarn over your hook again and pull through those final two loops, and that is a double crochet. And we're going to create a double crochet in each chain across. So the very next one, we're going to yarn over our hook, insert into the very next chain, grab your yarn, pull through the chain, you'll have your three loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through the first two loops, and yarn over, pull through the second two loops. And that's your second double crochet. And we're gonna keep doing that all the way across in each chain, and you'll have a total of 17 double crochets. And once we come to the end of this row, I just wanted to show you where we're gonna place our last double crochet. Right there by the knot where we created our slip knot, you want to make sure that you're placing your last half double crochet right there, and that's how your row should look. This is going to be the width of our headband, and each row that we do is going to create the length. So to start the next row, we're going to grab our yarn, pull through the loop, that's one chain, grab our yarn, pull through the loop, and that's a second chain. And then we're going to turn our work, and we're going to create a double crochet in that very first stitch. So right there at the top of the stitch, we're going to insert our hook, grab our yarn, pull through the stitch, grab your yarn, pull through the first two loops, grab your yarn, pull through the second two loops. And that's your first double crochet of the second row. Now we're going to create a front post double crochet, and I'm going to spread the stitches apart so you can see that line right there. That is our post. So we're going to yarn over our hook, and instead of inserting at the top of the stitch like we just did to create our double crochet, we're going to be doing a front post double crochet. So you're going to take your hook and have your post go over your hook like so. And I'll show you again. You're going to insert your hook over, under, like that. And then you're going to grab your yarn and pull behind that post. And then create your double crochet as you normally would. All right, and this is what the front post double crochet looks like. It is more 3D than our other stitches, and we're going to create another one of those right beside it. So again, I'm stretching out my stitches so you can see where the next post is. Insert under that post, and trying to show you all the angles so you can see where the hook placement is, and grab your yarn, pull underneath that post, and create your double crochet as normal. That's your second front post double crochet, and we're going to create another one right beside it. So you'll have a total of 3 front post double crochets. And now we're going to place a double crochet in the very next stitch right at the top. So this is a normal double crochet stitch placement. And what I like to do is flip my work over in the back and make sure that I skipped 3 stitches where we did our front posts. And now we're going to do 3 front post double crochets just like we did before. So you're going to go around the post of the next stitch, create your double crochet in the front post, and another one right beside it, going, having your post in front of your hook like so, and creating your front post double crochet. That's your second one, and we'll do it again for a third time. And then again, creating a double crochet in the very next stitch. And check to make sure that you skipped your three in the back. And you're going to repeat that three front post double crochets and then a double crochet in the next stitch all the way until the end. All right, I wanted to meet you at the end of the row. We just did three front post double crochets and we're going to end with a double crochet at the top of that chain three from the very first row. All right, and that is how our second row is going to look. And this is actually the back of our work. So to go ahead and move forward to row three, we're going to chain two and turn our work. And this is the front of our work, the right side. And now we are going to get started on row three. To start this row, we're going to create a front post double crochet around that very first post there on the edge. And then we're going to create a double crochet in the next stitch as normal, and then another double crochet, and a third double crochet. And then in this post where it's kind of popped up there, that is where we're going to create a front post double crochet. So you're going to go through. This one's a little easier to do because there's a nice gap there. And then you're going to create a double crochet in the next three stitches. And again, now that we come to that raised post there, we're going to create a front post double crochet around that post there. And we'll keep repeating that pattern of double crochet in the next three and front post around the next until the end. And now we're at the end of row three, and I wanted to show you that we're going to create a front post double crochet around that very last post there. So it's around the post, not the chain, so you'll still have a chain two on the side there. And that is how your finished row three will look for you. This is the front side of your work. And now we are going to chain two and turn and start on row four. This is the back side. So we're going to create a double crochet in that very first stitch. And over the next three stitches, you'll be doing front post double crochets. So you're going to slide your hook behind so your post is in the front and create your front post double crochets, and in the next stitch another front post double crochet and your third one. Now the pattern's starting to repeat itself and it should be easier for you to recognize where the stitches are going. Now we did our three and we're going to create a regular double crochet at the top of the stitch there in the next one, and again flipping your work, make sure you skipped those three stitches. And back to our repeat of three front post double crochets. So we're going to create a front post double crochet over these posts. And now that they're kind of grouped together, like I said, it's a little bit easier to tell where they go. And the pattern repeats now. All right, this is our third front post double crochet. And then we'll be placing a regular double crochet in the next stitch. And we'll keep repeating this pattern until the end. I'm meeting you at the end of row four, just to show you that we'll be putting a regular double crochet at the top there, at the very last stitch, creating a regular double crochet to end our row, and then we are going to chain two and turn our work, and this is the front of our work. Now you can see our squares taking place here, and now we are going to be getting started on row five. And this is going to be the same repeats of the two rows that we've been doing. So we're going to create a front post double crochet around that very first post there. And then a double crochet in the next three stitches. All right, we're on our third double crochet. And then we're going to create a front post double crochet around the next post, which is pretty prominent now. So you're going to create your front post double crochet around there and repeat this until the end of the row. All right, again, I'm going to meet you at the end of this row to show you that we are going to end with a front post double crochet around the last post, and that you'll still have that chain two on the side behind your hook there. So we're going to go around the post and then create our front post double crochet to end the row. And that's how the edge will look for you guys. And that is how your headband should be looking so far. And like I said, we're gonna just be repeating the last two rows that we did. Keep doing those repeats until we reach the length that we want. I did a total of 46 rows, which is enough for to fit a adult size head. So I'm gonna show you again. We're gonna chain two in turn and start with a double crochet in the very first stitch. And then we're gonna do a front post double crochet around the next three posts. This is a repeat of our rows here. And then you'll create a double crochet in the next stitch. And you can see where the double crochets are going now. They're a little indented. So that's where your double crochets will go. And then you'll repeat three. All right, and at the end of this row, you do a double crochet at the top of your stitch here to end your row. And then you chain two and turn. And now you're on to your second row repeat, which is where you're gonna do a double crochet front post around that very first post, double crochet in the next three, and then one double crochet front post. And you'll keep doing those two row repeats until you reach the length that you need, or again, until you reach row 46 like me, and we'll go ahead and end our headband together on screen. Welcome back, guys. This is what my headband is looking like now that I have my 46 rows, all the fun waffle stitch, all those fun squares, all the texture. It's so beautiful. Now we're going to end our headband, and to do that, we're going to grab our scissors and we're going to leave about 6 to 8 inches of yarn there before we cut. And then we're going to cut right there. And I like to grab my crochet hook, put it in the loop there, and act like I'm chaining one, but then I'm going to pull that yarn tail all the way through to create a knot to secure my ends. And then now we're going to want to grab our yarn needle. And then we're going to take our headband and fold it in half. So this is the back side of my headband, and I'm gonna fold it. So this, now I'm looking at the front, and I have my two short ends lined up together here. So these are my ends, and then I'm gonna take that yarn tail, thread it through my needle here. And once it's threaded, I will pick up my ends and make sure that the edges are lined up. And you're gonna insert your needle on the very first stitch on the edge there through the first piece, and then line it up to the edge stitch on the second piece and pull through both of them. And this is just a quick whip stitch, and then you're gonna go into the next stitch on the first piece and the second piece and keep them lined up and going through both sides and just pull the yarn through. And this is going to seam them both together to create the circle that will create our headband. And you'll keep going all the way until the end, lining up stitch for stitch. And this is the very last stitch that I wanted to just show it on camera. Make sure that you're going all the way to the edge there. And then I like to take the other yarn tail at the end and just knot them together. And then you're gonna take your yarn tail and your needle and you're gonna weave that through your piece just to hide your yarn tail and to secure them. So what I like to do is take my needle and insert it one way, going one way, and just pulling it through a few stitches like this. And then I also like to go in the opposite direction and maybe even a couple more directions. You just want to make sure that you're hiding it and securing it well. But once you go through a few different directions, you can cut it. And then you'll want to do the same thing with any and all other loose ends that you might have. All right, and once you guys do that, you are finished. Congratulations. That is the back of our headband with the seam there, and this is the front. Look how beautiful. I hope you guys enjoyed this crochet tutorial. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. And if you want to follow along with the written instructions for this pattern, I will go ahead and link that in the description below for you guys so you can get the PDF version. But that's it. This is your awesome waffle stitch headband. Enjoy, friends, and I'll meet you here next time for the next crochet or knit tutorial.